of a tip for bath and shower base manufacturers. This plastic here, this gauge, is the least you need to protect your goods. Otherwise, they're just going to get scratched by the consumer. So even if you just put it in a bag like this, then the consumer can attach it to the bath or shower base to protect it during the building process. With this trough, there's a lot of to and fro and putting it against the wall just to build frames and see where the screwing or the fixing points are. And it's got protection during that process. So that's what you really need to do with your baths and shower base. This unusual electrical work, I noticed that it comes right down close to the tap here. This is how the house was done about 40 years ago, the electrical work. And when my electrician gets here, I'll have to ask him how legal that is. This is resting right up against the tap there. That's how it was originally done. Okay, so I've screwed on a block of wood hard up against the sheet, the back wall. And I now have to cut out the passage for the pipe, and I'll have to check it in a bit to the wood, because this undergoes a fair amount of pressure when you're putting in the thread and attaching the outlet. So that's got to be fairly sturdy there. I'll do that with brackets here and here, and so now I'll get to work doing that. Ideally, you should use cement sheet in a laundry. However, I've made the choice to use normal plasterboard just on this wall. It's well away from the wet area, like the washing machine and the trough, etc. And I'm going to have it up off the ground in case it floods a bit. At the moment we're just building the frame for the bottom of the dryer. See, out here the dryer at the bottom has supports. These are the supports, they're wrapped up in tape, but that area there, that hooks in and that sticks out and that, you know, rests on the wall. The top of the dryer's got a frame like that, and that just sits into there, and I'll have to build some sort of framework for this to screw into, and they'll go up there. So at the moment I'm doing the bottom support. Yeah, it's amazing how many mistakes and products you buy that are damaged or scratched or that don't fit or don't do the job. It's actually a big percentage of the time needed to renovate a room. This next issue is with IKEA. I bought a cupboard 150 wide, and I sell a cupboard 150 and also 2 meter wide. And what's happened is the girl, I don't know how she's done this, because it's all computerized and aisle numbers is all automated. She sold me baskets and clothes rails for a 2 meter wide cupboard when I bought a 150 wide cupboard. So the actual frame is these two items here, and everything that goes in it is too wide. So I have to take it all the way back, buy the right stuff, and bring it back here and install it. Okay, so you can see you might be able to see there, that's 150, 1 meter 500. And that's the basket I was sold, and that's the clothes rail. So that comes all the way out to there. They're the other baskets there. That's a clothes rail. they're all too wide, but the frame is okay, so that's the main thing, and I can go ahead and build that. Anyway, Merry Christmas. It's Christmas morning. So, Christmas morning 2013. This is a flint lighter. Just really sandpaper. You make sure all your joins are sandpapered, and so that's the inside of the joiner and the outside of the pipe. And you get some flux and put that on where the join will be. No flux, then it doesn't work, so very important. Inside of your joiners. Ask for AquaSafe. That's AquaSafe. Aqua being water. I don't know in what language, maybe Latin or something like that, but AquaSafe solar. To light your gas bowl, just get a flint lighter or a barbecue lighter, and you actually let the flint fall in the top of the gas burner there. I'll let my flame burn at about that heat, not full blast and not really low, but just about around about there. I won't show all the heating process, it takes a while to warm it up. Just start warming it up, curl your flux a little bit so you can get in and around the join. Don't forget to protect your hands, protect your skin, just wear gloves. Keep a water bottle handy just to wet down the frame around the flame when you solder, and in case anything goes wrong.